they decided to have it in his constituency. And there was a huge outcry from his constituents. So he had to come up and say a few words. And he said that, well, we should have a master plan to look into how we can properly house some of these foreign workers. And then after years of getting, you would have thought that a plan would have been put in place in terms of just infrastructure, in terms of housing, and so on and so forth. And nothing was done. And all this then culminated in the riot in Little India. And then when the Commission of Inquiry held, we found that the police were not prepared. There wasn't enough personnel. And when push came to shove, the equipment was communications equipment wasn't working properly. So you have all these big problems coming in where the infrastructure is not taken care of. MRT continues to face all these the breakdowns. 2010, the Minister of Health said there was a bed crunch, and a lot of your patients had to just put in on long corridors and stuff. And he promised it won't happen again. Well, guess what? 2014, same thing happened. Now we had to build tents outside the hospital just to cater for this overflow of these patients. Now, people see all these things. And then they get angry because despite all these shortcomings, the government then announces that we want to push our population up to 6.9 million. Singaporeans expect our political leaders to be mature and to debate on the issues. In this regard, the SDP strives to be the grown-up in the room, and we encourage PAP to do the same. I'm not going to sit here and paint the PAP as all bad and the opposition as all good. I acknowledge, coming from me might seem a bit strange, but I acknowledge that there are PAP MPs who genuinely want to serve the people. But at the same time, I want the PAP to admit that there are those of us in the opposition who want to do good for this country. Going back to 2008, when the financial crisis came up, and that was admitted by both GIC and Temasek, they lost something in the tune of between $120 to $140 billion. And that's almost half of the foreign reserves that we think they hold. If Washington, D.C. had not come up with TARP, the Troubled Assets Relief Program, if Obama had not bailed out some of these companies, Merrill Lynch and your Citigroup and your Barclays, your Lehman Brothers and so on, this money would have been gone. So it's been encouraging. If I had a dollar for every time somebody came up to me and said, I didn't know, I believe that what the state media was doing was saying about you. If I had a dollar for that, everybody came up to me, I'd be as rich as the ministers. But this shows the power of the state media that had gone this time. People were just so misled and keep thinking that I was going to drag Singapore down. People have heard what they've heard of me is what the PAP has said of me, and not what I've been able to directly communicate with them. That's all going to change in this election as well. As I said in my opening presentation, I hope that's not the tone or the strategy that the PAP is going to adopt in this election. If they do, they're going to be in for a nasty surprise. Given the problems that we have right now in this country, are you going to stick to your strategy of just going to name call? And I don't think the Singaporean public is going to move for it. I know, Lee Kuan, you said you were years ago, says, without foreign workers, there wouldn't be jobs in the first place. And then Lee Hsien-Loong then comes along and echoes that and says, without foreign workers, we wouldn't be able to attract investment. Just imagine, another leader of the country say that Obama or Merkel or Jokowi is saying that. I mean, after 50 years, uninterrupted rule, they could do anything that they wanted in those 50 years.
said right at the beginning of the 60s, says, if I could govern without having to go back to the people and ask for their consent, I have no doubt that I'd be able to govern better in their interest. Well, guess what? After 50 years, you're telling us that even us local Singaporeans cannot survive economically without having to depend. Sure, foreigners come in, expatriates come in, they complement our economy. But it cannot be the pillar on which our economy rests. And this is where